Often the chase to fulfill our desires can lead us down very dark roads and a life full of regrets. How does it happen and how do we remedy this? Hello and welcome back to my channel. Happy New Month! How have you been? My name is Judy Owiti, I'm a youth mentor and I'm just so glad that you're watching. God created us living and breathing humans with built-in desires. You know, for example, a desire to seek a spiritual connection, a desire to be loved, a desire to feel secure. These desires are good. The problem comes when we seek wrong ways to fulfill these desires, ways that have nothing to do with God. The thing with these desires is that they can lead us down paths we never thought we would go. And the more we go down those paths, the more we develop habits and behaviors that lead us to self-destruct and self-sabotage. I'll give you an illustration. Now, the Eskimos are among the greatest hunters of the world, but there's one animal that is the most difficult for them to catch, the white wolf. It has a sense of smell that can detect a human from 2 miles away. Its eyesight is great. It's very cunning, which makes it very hard for the Eskimos to bring it down. And yet the Eskimo has to trap and kill this animal, otherwise it will destroy their way of life. And so the Eskimo has devised a tactic to kill it. Now, in order to kill the white wolf, the Eskimos take a knife and they sharpen it to a razor's edge. Then they take it out to freeze. Then they bring it back and dip it in blood. And then they take it out to freeze. Then they bring it back into the house. Now they repeat this process over and over again until there's a thick coat of frozen blood on the knife. And then they take it out into the wilderness and they plant it in the ground, blade up. Now the wolf, scenting what is on the blade, is drawn by that blood. And so he makes his way to the knife and he starts to lick. And so he licks, nothing happens. And he licks again and nothing happens. And so he starts to lick and lick, and he's licking it fast and fast and enjoying himself. As he keeps licking more and more, his tongue numbs from the cold and he doesn't even notice the sharp blade is exposed. His craving for the taste of blood is so great that he does not even realize his thirst is being satisfied by his own blood. So he licks the blade until it's too late and he bleeds to death, swallowing his own life. Now the sad part is, this happens to us too. You know, the devil has studied us and he knows our weaknesses. He knows our wicked desires and he knows what we are attracted to in order to fulfill those desires. He knows the things we respond to. And just like the white wolf, we never really notice the hidden blade until it's too late. Because our spirit has grown numb. We no longer listen to that still voice in us that tells us this is wrong. You know, don't do this. And we have just grown numb to the Holy Spirit. That first sexual experience that leads to a life of sexual immorality, sexually transmitted diseases, cheating in your relationships, and a trail of broken hearts. That first drink that leads to a life of alcoholism and pain. That first look at pornography that has led to addiction and you being consumed by guilt and worthlessness. That desire and obsession for material things that will get you to do anything in order to get material things. You'll sleep around, you'll bribe your way. Sin by nature is so deceitful. You know, the devil always promises one thing and he delivers quite the opposite. I mean, think about it. In the Garden of Eden, he tells Eve, if you eat of this fruit, you will not die. But Eve ended up dying. Sin is packaged so attractively. You know, it looks like it's a cool thing. You only need to look at the TV and see the advertisements and look at the movies and just see how the sin has been packaged in a way that speaks to our desires. The sex, the cigarettes, the alcohol, all these things are packaged to look cool and appealing. Nobody tells you about the pain of sexual immorality, the devastation of alcoholism on families and how it breaks families, or lung cancer that comes because of smoking. The emphasis is more on the pleasure of sin than on the consequences of sin. So what can we do? The question that we need to ask ourselves is this desire that we have leading us to God's will, or is it leading us to our own destruction? We need to realize that nothing created can satisfy us. It was never meant to. Only God can satisfy the deep longings of our heart. We need to take all our desires and just put them at the feet of Jesus. When we give Jesus our life, we surrender to God's will. We start to seek Him and His ways. And you know, when our heart is in tune with God's heart, He starts to deal with us. He starts to deal with our desires, and He gives us desires that are aligned to His will. That's it for me today. I hope this was helpful to you in some way. Stay blessed, stay safe, and I will see you next time.